Before we start with today's story, I have to make mention that there is a big scam going on from Ledger or from people who are impersonating accounts at Ledger. And they are sending out text messages and emails and everything else for people to go to their sites, download some type of software, or asking for their private keys and or their mnemonic phrases or their passphrases. So if you see something like this, just know that it is a scam. Do not give anybody anything. Your private keys stay private. Your mnemonic phrases or your recovery phrases are for you. So do not fall into this and lose everything. These are from unscrupulous scammers that are trying to take down a good thing. So also, if you are in the market for a Nano Ledger, it's fantastic. I got four myself. I keep all of my different assets on there. You can pick them up today for 20% off. All you have to do is just when you add it to your cart and click on checkout, all you have to do is type in digital asset news, click apply, and 20% off. To get the official link, just look in the description of every one of my videos. There's gonna be a link that goes to Nano Ledger. It looks something like this right here, and off you go. All right, let's start the show. Welcome to Digital Asset News. Take a top stories in cryptocurrency, digital assets, and break them down to bite-sized pieces. Today, got some good stuff, some positive and bullish news. First up, Zcash is on its way to its first halving, and it's going to happen on 18th of November. Also, fantastic news, Cardano releases the Gogan roadmap and demos the ERC-20 converter on their show. So I'm gonna talk to you how important Gogan is and really how much more important this ERC-20 converter is to you, me, on top of all the different industries that have already built on Ethereum and ERC-20. Also, Bitcoin is just 4 days away from historically bullish 10K price record. Why this is important and why it could lead, based on data analytics, to $100,000 Bitcoin. However, I don't think it's going to happen. There's a story that correlates what I'm talking about. As Bitcoin suddenly slides 4%, as Bank of America predicts a 20% stock market crash. And we'll get into all that, but first take a look at what's going on in the market. So today is October 30th. It is about 1 p.m. Texas time. And what do we have going on? Well, Bitcoin has indeed slumped just a little bit, and it's at 13.5. Not too bad on the predication of a potential stock market crash 20%. So we'll see how that works out. But it is up 4.3 for the week. Ethereum is down 2.9. Tether's 0.3. XRP is down as well. Bitcoin Cash. You know, really, we should just talk about what's up, because it seems like there's nothing really too fantastic. 7% down for crypto.com. Ouchie. Hey, Leo tokens up 0.4. That's fantastic news. Just kidding, it's 0.4. Filecoin down 11%. This project looks so good. I don't know why it keeps going down. It's all about allocation of resources and paying next to nothing for cloud storage. So if Filecoin can do that from anywhere, I don't see the problem, unless it's just an issue with price action. Dash is up 5%. That's good. Zcash is up 3.3, which we're going to get in that right now. I'm pretty sure I know what that is. And then Celsius Network is up 1.4. You know, this is the day, my dollar cost average day is for Celsius and Theta. And of course, Celsius is the only one to go up. What a bummer. But over the next months and years, I'm going to be investing heavily into Theta and Celsius. Anyhow, let's jump into today's top story. While this isn't a very top story about what's going to happen, but I just want everybody to realize why Zcash could be pumping or dumping in the next roughly 2.5 weeks or so. So this is from nicehash.com, which is a little countdown for Zcash. If you don't know, Zcash is a fork of Bitcoin. It is a privacy coin. And I always thought privacy coins were dead until Gemini came out with the announcement a couple weeks ago, 2 or 3 weeks ago, that said they're allowing people to use private transactions to send to anybody any amount and for whatever they want to do with it. And this was after years of working with a New York financial institution to get them to actually do this. So when I saw this, I was surprised. I thought they were all going to go away because other exchanges were delisting these privacy coins, but here we are. So Zcash, just remember that November 18th is the date of when it's going to have a halving. Now, it could be a little bit sooner, it could be a little later, depending on how many blocks get mined. But I think what usually happens with halvings is that there's a huge amount of hype around it. And as we get closer, it starts to increase. And afterwards, it dumps, or it dumps right before, depending. So if you're a trader, this is a great opportunity. If you're looking at things to invest into, if you believe in the project, sure. But just be aware of that's why the price will probably go up over the next 2.5 weeks. That's what I want to say. Just want to be transparent and show everybody what's going to happen. So let's jump into what I think is the big news item of the day.